we should have recorded that. We're going to be playing some more Paranormal PI. And today we're going to do a different house. And we're going to do a little smaller house on this map. Do this one. I think it's this one.
This client contacted me a few days back saying they believe they're having paranormal experiences. They mentioned this has been going on a while, but wasn't sure who to contact. They were telling a friend about what they are experiencing, and the friend recommended they call the office, which is great they reached out. Sounds like while they are in the garage, or just outside of it, most of the activity has occurred. The first few times they heard something drop or fall over, they thought nothing of it. Several months have passed by since this commotion first caught their attention. It has now become so frequent they're convinced it's not rationally explained. Most recently, the homeowner had witnessed something being thrown across the garage. They did not see where the object landed because they are on the other side of the car, but it did make a noise when it landed. So they went around the car to check it out and pick up any mess. When they walked around the car, nothing was out of place. They stated this startled them because they knew something should have been on the floor where they heard the crash. I'm sure I'll be able to find enough evidence to support their claims and put their minds at ease.
There's a ghost in the garage this time. And where's the garage? I had to go to their house to get to it. Okay. An older house. So let's go to the garage. And we'll just start our investigation here. Not a camera. See if we get any readings. Nothing yet. Did the car get readings? No. I don't know if that door should be open or not. This door. This is the backyard. I'm sure nothing happened back here. Let's try with the thermometer first. And close this door. Okay. Check in here too. A little bit of drop. Know that means anything. It's just hotter in the garage. Oh, I should have recorded that. Motion of voice recorder? No. Three. Okay, so. I pick up intimators yet. Should we just wait? Getting cold spots. clap the air vents, make it drop. But the garage is not a very big space to explore.
Wasn't quick enough with the recorder.
Let's get the EMF out. Refrigerator. Open a door. Big. Oh, no, it's a refrigerator. Not really picking up anything. Let's go back in. We will do it again. Something's falling, but I don't know what it's throwing. Come on, do it again. And as soon as I switch over, it's gonna try to turn the lights off. Sometimes they ramp up when you turn the lights off. I can't eat my readings yet. So if they're saying that he's throwing stuff, it's probably most likely it's Poltergeist. I'll go back in the garage, see what'll do it. Pick up anything. I mean, I was hearing sounds earlier, but then I was too late to catch it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the refrigerator. Not sure what's it doing now. Let's look at our notes. Let's see what we get. Activity in and around the garage. So maybe outside too. Let's read about Poltergeist real quick. Temperature drop will occur prior to activity. Okay. An EMF spike after. Yeah, I should get that thermometer out. Got around us. Should I go out here? That temperature drop? Come on. To play this game, you gotta be very patient. What were you throwing me for? Is constant in here. There's no temperature drop. In here, but it's colder in here. Yeah. Oh, wait.
These temp readings are unusual.
Right here.
Something is going on here. These temperature readings are definitely paranormal.
Got temperature reading going on there. It's probably gonna make a noise. All right, come on, do something. Should I try talking to it? Do an EVP session right here.
Just leaving the recorder on makes for a lot of post-investigation work. Is there anyone here who would like to speak with me? I'm going to listen to that real quick. Is there anyone here who would like to speak with me?
Nope.
Do you know why I'm here? I I wonder if I recorded anything. Do you know why I'm here?
If the porch gun, I'm pretty sure it's not going to answer me, but you never know. Traveling there right now. Come on, ghost, do something. Oh, it's outside now. Where'd it go? Yeah, Dev was out here. I moved.
I wasn't quick enough with the recorder.
See, I mean, I always do stuff when I'm not holding a recorder in my hand. Let's see if it'll drop here again. What is it messing with? Come on. Make yourself known. Oh, it's dropping, it's dropping, it's dropping. So outside around the garage.
Wasn't quick enough with the recorder.
What do you say, get thrown? We're lagging right now. All right. Wait till it drops again. Well, I have to say this investigation is the hardest one because, I mean, it's not really much to explore if the ghost is in the garage. Constant temperature. Come on. If they drop, come on.
Nothing here worth recording. As soon as I hear a noise, I'll press record. I must actively catch video evidence. I must actively catch video evidence. Once I see a ghost, I'll snap a picture.
Boxes. Okay. See the EMF here. But the fridge makes that. Okay. Drop again? Come on. Just stand here when you do something.
I'll keep that as audio evidence.
Thank you.
Investigating with the camera recording all night results in hours of post-investigation work.
I keep forgetting what buttons to press for her.
These lights are acting funny. I should continue investigating. I wasn't quick enough with the recorder.
EMF in this corner?
The EMF meter should not behave this way. This is paranormal.
Okay. Getting more audio sound. And since I got more evidence, it should be increasing up activity. Ramp it up here. Ramp it up.
Ooh, that is eerie audience.
Let's see if we take a picture of that.
Wow, it had enough energy to make a mess? This with the recorder evidence supports a poltergeist being present. Wow, that's great audio evidence.
What you guys talk? We'll see. Let's be there for a second. It's quiet often. Yes, they are intelligent. They may get it to talk.
Is this your home? I'm going to listen to that real quick. Is this your home? Why are you here? Let's play that back and have a listen. Why are you here? Is there anyone here who would like to speak with me? I'm going to listen to that real quick. Is there anyone here who would like to speak with me? Is there anything you'd like to tell me? I wonder if I recorded anything. Is there anything you'd like to tell me? How many people are here other than me? I wonder if I recorded anything. How many people are here other than me? Do you like the current family living here?
My activity.
I wonder if I recorded anything. Do you like the current family living here? Can you tell me your name? I wonder if I recorded anything. Can you tell me your name?
All right. Listen there. Let me get more picture evidence and any more audio. This out.
Multiple ghost photos will help solidify evidence. I wasn't quick enough with the recorder. I'm not going to record white noise and then spend hours listening to it.
Three and five. Keep them going.
I should turn the recorder back on. I wasn't quick enough with the recorder.
I did twice by accident. So you turned the recorder off. Anymore?
That's extraordinary audio evidence.
Should tell us how much evidence I need. I pretty much think that's all we're going to get from this ghost. So, I think you are confirmed that they have, must have got notes actually. Yep, got their temperature drops. Got EMF. More than three pieces of audio. So we're just gonna finish that out. Oops. Yeah, I definitely got Poltergeist here, I guess. What was it? Let's finalize it and see what score we get. Got all email, got all temperatures, got all photos, and all evidence, got everything. Alright. There's no reason for concern. Well, there you go, you got your Poltergeist. But that's it for today. If you want to see more of this video, please like and subscribe. And as always, thank you for watching.